my channel Art Saga and to the new tutorial video How to Draw Stairs by Compulent. If you are new to this channel, please check the previous videos and like and subscribe the channel. So guys, let's start. In previous tutorial, we learned about how to draw a section and we also started a new topic of stair and roofs. So today we will go and start with stair. Stair is a big topic, so I will be covering it in one or two or three tutorials. So today we will start with stair by component. In upcoming tutorials, we will also cover stair by sketch pattern. So today we will go by stair by components. So you can find stair in architecture and in circulation tab, and you can find here stair. When you click on it, it will say go to a view, because a stair can be drawn in the floor plan or a 3D view. So what we'll do, we will just choose a plan and we'll go to a plinth level plan, because I want my stair from plinth level to the first floor level or maybe above. So we will start drawing a stair from plinth level now. So I will select on stairs. So here we can see a modify section tab is activated, and here we have options of run, landing, support. Here are some default Revit staircase, and you can also create a stair by sketch. We will focus on this topic in the upcoming tutorials. Today we'll learn about the straight staircase. So when I will select this, after selecting this, I am taking my mouse to the draw field and I will draw the staircase, and I will just click from one end to another and say finish, and here my staircase is ready. What I will do, I will go to 3D and show you how the staircase looks. So here is our staircase. The staircase is from the plinth level to the first floor level. So we will go and just check the elevation. So yes, the staircase is from the plinth level to the first floor level. So while drawing a stair, you must know its components, like what are tread, what is riser, railings, baluster and stringers. So in Revit, we have an option to change the dimensions of every component. So right now, if I select on the stair and I go to the property section panel, the constraint is plinth level to first floor level, and the dimensions, which is desired number of risers. So desired number of risers are 17. The actual number is 17, yes. The riser height, so the height, this height is 176.5 mm, and the actual tread depth, so the tread depth on which we keep our foot, is 275 mm. So you can also change it. So you can change it before drawing the staircase, or you can change it after drawing a staircase. So let's change it before and draw a staircase. So I have selected a staircase, I have selected a straight staircase. Let's say I want 20 risers. It would automatically convert the riser height to 150, and let's say I want the tread depth to be 300, and I'll say okay. I'll just go to edit type and check again. So this should be 150 and this should be 300, and the maximum run width, so the length, sorry, the width of the staircase, I want it to be 1200, let's say, and apply, and I'll say okay, and I'll draw a staircase now. So I'll just draw a straight staircase again, and I'll say okay. Again I'll go to 3D, and you can see, I'll show you now, the height is same, just the angle is different. Staircase which I drew before had less number of risers, so the angle is more. As soon as I increase the number of risers, the staircase angle is low, and both the staircase are aligned to the first floor level. So it is correct. So you can change the number of risers and you can change the width of the tread as you want. So now again I'll select staircase, and I just want staircase from this area to here only. Now you can see there are number of risers. I can create more number of risers. So I have 7 risers created and I have 14 remaining. So let's say I just want to have 7 risers in my project, and I'll say yes, and I'll say okay. But there will be a warning sign that stair top exceeds or cannot reach the top elevation of the stair. So I have not utilized all the given risers, but I don't have an issue. I just want my 7 risers to be in place, and I have selected okay. So my staircase is drawn now. Again, I'll go to 3D. I'll show you a different angle. Okay, here we go. So my staircase is only drawn till here. So I just wanted to have the staircase till here only. So this is my stair. Now again, I'll go to my plinth level. So we have drawn certain types of stairs. Now I want to include a landing in between my stairs. Like if I want an L-shaped stair or a straight stair with a landing or a U-shaped stairs. So how we can draw it? So I'll go to stair. I'll draw my risers till here. So my 9 risers, let's say 10 risers are created. I will move my mouse up and I want to draw stairs from here to above again. So I'll just click from here to here. So as soon as I've clicked, the gap in the between has a landing now. So if I say finish, my staircase is done. And if I go to 3D, I can see a landing here. Similarly, you can also create a L-shaped stair. So if I go to stair, I'll select 10 risers, and I want my stairs to be on this side. So I'll just select it. I'll select it from here and let's say okay. And I'll say finish. Again, go to 3D, and I have a landing in between and my stair is in L shape. Now there is one problem. The intersection is not very good here. So what I'll do, I'll just undo it. I'll just go back. I'll select the stair again, and you can see a location line. So this is basically a stair path on which you want to draw a stair. So if I select left, the stair path will start from the left side. So if I said I want 10 stairs here, now I want the stair on from this side, for exactly from this end. Now if I select left, it would draw my staircase on the bottom part. So what I'll do, I'll just go to location line again. I will select right. I will select this point, exactly my stair would start from this point, but on the right side. So there would be a good intersection there. And you can see the intersection is quite better than before. So if I do yes, and if I go to 3D, now my staircase is properly drawn here. Now I will draw a U-shaped staircase. So again, I'll go to stair. I'll select straight. I will go from this point, I will create 10 risers. I will leave this gap, and again I will start from this point. So whenever I start, you can see something in the background. So a landing is created from the gap of the two stair paths. So I will draw it till here and say yes and say finish. And I'll go to 3D. So you can see a landing is connected between two stair flights. So now after finishing the stair, if I want to change the width of the landing or move the stairs, if I want to reduce the gap between two flights, I can do that. What I'll do, I'll just select the stair, double click on it, and I can just select this flight and I want this gap to be less. So what I'll do, I'll just use arrow keys and move my stair flight to the another stair flight, and I will say finish. The stairwell gap is less and the landing is also automatically adjusted. So if I will go to 3D, I can see this. So the landing is adjusted. Now we will learn about spiral staircase. So I'll go to architecture, stair, and in modifier section, I will select full step spiral. So I'll just see my desired number of risers are 20, and I'll say okay. And I'll select the stair pattern. So my radius is like, let's say 1300 or more. Okay, I'll keep it more. And this is 200. And I'll say finish. And my stair is, the spiral stair is ready. So I can see the spiral stair in the 3D view also. If I want to reduce the radius, I'll just again click it, select it. And I will zoom in and I can see the radius is 1400. What I'll do, I'll just reduce it to 1000 and finish. So you can see the radius is less now. If I go to 3D and see, this is my staircase now. So I can even change the radius and the width of tread and riser and the height of the riser after I draw the staircase also. So now we will go to another stair, which is stair by end spiral. So center end spiral. So you need to select the center point first. You need to select the end point then. After selecting the end point, you need to select the number of risers you want. So as soon as I drag my mouse onto the stair path, I can see 20 risers is created and one is remaining. So I've selected all 21 risers and I'll say okay. But I just want 20 risers here. I'll say 20, and this is actual height. Riser height is 150, tread depth is 300. I will say finish and my staircase is created. So this is my staircase. So what we did is we selected the center point first, we selected the end point, and we selected the number of risers we want. Let's draw stair by center end again, and I will add a landing in between. So I have selected a center point, I have selected end point. I just want my 10 risers to be here. Again, I will select a center point. I will select a, let's say, a end point. I will create my risers here and I will say okay. So you can create a weird shape staircase or a different shape of staircase on a spiral staircase also. So I started from here, I have a landing, and again I have drawn a circular staircase on a same angle, same center point. So if I go on 3D, I can see I have started from here, I have a straight landing. And again, I have created a staircase in a curved pattern. So here you can draw any shape and size of staircase by using curved pattern. Now we will learn about another type, which is a L-shaped winder. So I will tell you what are the winders. So I will just select the staircase and say 20 risers. I don't know why it is selecting 21 again and again. I will just paste it here. So it has, and I will finish. So these are the winders. So this type of staircase does not have a landing. So it has winders. So winders are these parts. So on the landing part, so you can see some lines. I'm just moving my mouse over that part, and these steps are called winders, which are on the angular path of the staircase. Now again, if I double click on this staircase, I can change some settings of the winders. So if I select it, I can see the winder style is balanced. If I go and drop down and say it to single point, this would change. So this does not look very nice. So we will have it balanced. Now you can also change the inside walk line offset and the minimum width of inside boundary also. There is one option of parallel tread at the start. So you can see the only two tread are parallel to each other, and every other tread are on a different angle. Same goes to the side of the end of the staircase. Only two risers are parallel to each other, and all other treads are on another angle. So you can change it. See, let's say I want three risers at the start to be parallel and three at the end to be parallel. So I'll click three here. And I can see 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So these three treads are parallel to each other. Similarly, I can say I want 5 on both sides, and I will have 5 risers, 5 treads on parallel to each other. When I make these parallels, these angles, these winder angles would change. And I will say finish, and I will go to 3D. Here is my staircase. So my winder staircase is ready. Now I'll go to plinth level, and we have a last type of staircase, which is a U-shaped winder staircase. it's just the same staircase like L shape. Sorry, it's the same staircase like winder staircase, but it is just in a U shape. So I will just click it here and say finish, and this is created. I will go to 3D and I can check this. I can check the U shape staircase. You can also change the winder size and winder length, the offset and the winder style to be balanced or single point. Let's say you want four or five risers which are parallel at the start and end. You can do similarly, same as the L-shaped winder staircase. So here are our types of staircase. So what we learned today is the straight staircase. A straight staircase with landing, a L-shaped staircase with a landing, a U-shaped staircase with a landing, a spiral staircase, a spiral end and center staircase. A spiral staircase with a landing and a winder staircase which is in L shape and U shape. So in next tutorial we will learn about how to draw stair by sketch. So you can draw different type of staircase of any angle and any size by using sketch pattern. So please like and share this tutorial and stay tuned for my next videos. Thank you.